Okay, our new motor is on, all coupled up, ready to go. The RPM is set the same as the other one, close to. So let's give it a run up and see how we go. So we have to beat, standard only went for 8 minutes 47 seconds at 54.7 watt hours per 100 mils, which we have in there. And we will start the test as soon as we get down to our 100 mil line. So I remember to turn the fuel on this time. We'll get it running, see how we go. Okay, there you go. So we now have our base figures. The RPM was a little lower, but doesn't matter. Within 40 to 50 RPM, 13.31 minutes, 72 watt hours, as opposed to our initial first run with our standard 2 horsepower side valve motor of 54.7 watt hours. We can clearly see that the big motor does a better job straight up. Perhaps because the larger motor doesn't have to work as hard, but being a larger motor, it still consumes more fuel when it's not working as hard, so I would say it's more than likely the difference between a side valve and an overhead valve motor. A little hard to make the comparison because two different size motors. But overhead valve motors are definitely more efficient. If I had an overhead cam, it's probably more efficient again. But at these RPMs, the valve train's not going to matter too much. Biggest problem with pushrod engines is you can only rev them so high before the valves start to float, which means they can't close quick enough due to the mass that it's got to push back, right back down to the cam. The pushrods, cam followers, rockers, valves themselves, whereas an overhead cam, well, you've got the cam and the rockers, and like in some motorcycles, you don't even have them, you just have shims. So that's our starting point. I did get temperature measurements and that. I'll write them down when we have a look at the video, but that's where we're starting at. So now we're just going to go ahead and do the main jet, and I'm also going to rip the head off. Actually, I'll do the main jet first, we'll run it, rip the head off, shave a mill off it, put it back on, see how we go. Once we've got this motor running as efficiently as we can, we'll plug on the HHO and see how we go.